Alrighty then, good morning everyone, welcome to the stream. We're bringing my stream up right momentarily here, because we're going to be doing an Aslan's Guide for my fellow Philo members and anybody else who wishes to ascertain a little bit of information for this. How we get to Aslan's, if you're unfamiliar with Aslan's, he's a really good guy. So all you have to do is just do a quick search for Aslan's World of Warship Mods, which I've already got. Pop in over here, click on Aslan's Forms, and you can see, if you scroll down a little bit, he offers mod packs for World of Tanks and World of Warships. So just click on World of Warships, then you're just going to come down here to these download links. I always recommend using the direct links. Do not use these download links, because it always asks you to put a bunch of crap on your computer that you don't really need. So just use the direct links, okay, and then download it. And once you do that, I've already got it stored on my computer, so I don't have to worry about that. But just go ahead and run it, and then we'll show you which of the ones that I prefer to use. Since I've already got it stored on my computer, let's bring it up. You can click in this box, and I always highly recommend it to show preview window. So click on that, just click next, click next. Now, here's what our mod pack installer looks like. You're gonna get a whole bunch of options when you bring it up, but if you notice, I don't use very few of them. I only basically use the ones that are beneficial to me, like the crosshairs. A lot of this stuff is already actually incorporated into the game, or it changes things in the game that I don't like, so I don't recommend using any of this stuff. So ship core, ship contour icons, just leave this blank. You don't need any of this stuff. So if you notice, I don't have any of nothing. I don't use anything until we come down here to crosshairs. And then if you see down here, these are the crosshairs that I prefer to use, because they make aiming and leading targets super easy. I have crab version 1, but I usually prefer to use crab version 2. And to show you the difference, crab version 1, if you notice, it doesn't have the circles around, and it doesn't have the markers on the lines, but it is the exact same crosshair. So when you're aiming and leading targets, it's the exact same principles apply for that. So, and I'll kind of show you the difference here. Crab version 2, if you notice, it has these circles around the bottom. So if you launch a plane in the air, you will actually change the method of aiming. You'll actually be kind of aiming from above the target instead of straight on. So if you're good, you can actually use these circles as an aiming point, or additional aiming point. And as you all can also see, it's got a little bit more markers on the gun sight. So I'm switching back to that one. And then as you can see, I don't use anything else. We're leaving a lot of stuff empty. All of these gun markers, all of this stuff, a lot of it's in the game already. You don't really need it. But there are different, you know, I mean, there's so many different, just to show you, there are different kind of gun mods that you can use if you prefer different types of crosshairs. But again, I prefer the crab version 2. And let me see, this one, no, that's not what I kind of thought it was, but that's okay. But if you want more visual range finders and stuff like that, you can use that. I don't bother with that stuff. Come down here to mod sharing, hub SWF file, and I do use these. If you notice that they're just detection icons, you can choose skulls, you can choose whatever, you know, which ones you prefer. I prefer just the yellow ones, because these, when you get detected, but what they're for, the purpose of them is that you, when you get detected by an enemy ship, and if you can see, these will actually light up. They're brighter and they're actually easier to see and notice than the default icons in the game. So that's why I prefer them. I just use the yellow ones, but you can use, you know, whichever you prefer. I mean, these ones here are fine, you know, so this is all going to come down to personal choice. But whichever you know, detection markers you choose, they are going to be very beneficial to you, because again, you can see them far better than the the default ones in the game. And then I come down here, target lock markers, the same principle. You can use any color you want. I prefer just to use the red one, and again, it just kind of shows up better and is more visible than the default one in the game. These compass elements, this will just change the appearance of your compass in the game. I prefer shape 2 because it adds the degrees as well as the compass. It's just a personal thing. You can use compass elements, you don't have to. It's just a purely cosmetic, personal you know, thing, if you want to use that or you use that not. Same thing with this hit markers down here. As you can see, when you're getting hit by an enemy ship, it does, again, the same purpose. It's more visible in the game. It's better than the default ones in the game. And once again, you can use pretty much any ones that you want. But these are for your torpedo warnings. And I, you know, same principle right when we come down here. They're a little bit more visible. I use these torpedo warning version 2 because they do stand out a little bit more, and they're easily detectable over even the other ones that you can get in the mod pack. And again, far more visible than the ones, the default ones that are in the game. And then again, you notice I don't have anything else in the game or, you know, from that point on. I just have session stats. Again, this is all just will tell you, you know, give you battle information, how well you're doing. I do use this one, extended tech tree. It adds the hidden and unavailable ships to the tech tree, so you will be able to see a little bit more premium ships, the ships that are not normally visible with the default user face. I do use this one. As you can see, it allows me to use more than one. And I can't remember if this may or may not have been added to the game. I've never really checked, but I always just use it because it gives me 2 rows or even 3 or even 4 rows of visual ships instead of just the default one. Then I throw clear vision on, because you can see it just clears things up a little bit. And then once again, I don't use anything. We skip a bunch of crap. And then we come down here, and now the stuff that we kind of get into is purely cosmetic. You can get down here, you can add custom shells and tracer color contrails. I like to use this one, my AP, and you probably notice this, but it turns my AP shells blue, and excuse me, my HE shells red, and my my colored AP rounds blue. It just adds a little bit more color to the game and helps me visualize them a little bit better. But again, this is just a total personal thing. If you want to keep the default ones, they are fine. And you have all kinds, although some of them, you know, they get a little bit crazy as far as I'm concerned. like this one here, and there's actually another one that's completely like electric. But anyway, I prefer just the first one. That's plenty. You can actually even come down here and hide your tracer, so all you see is just the shells themselves. But again, all purely cosmetic. I don't use it. I don't think it's actually necessary. So I try to keep as much of the default settings, game's default settings, as I can. So then we come down here again. I don't use any of this stuff. It's all cosmetic. But there is one that I'm looking for. Info panel enemy. This one I do use. I highly recommend it. It is very important, because what this does, and I'll show you when we get back in the game, and adds this panel to your HUD. And whenever you put your crosshairs on an enemy ship, it'll give you important information. But the one that's really important is this one right here. It'll actually tell you what speed that enemy ship is currently traveling at. So it'll help you with leading your target and putting your shells on target and hitting your enemy a lot better. And again, we don't have anything else. Then I just come down here. Again, this is just entirely cosmetic. It's, you know, a personal thing if you want to use it or if you don't. They're just cute crew voices. You can change the
it's a trap.
The sound of your you know, the voices. It's just a voice mod pack, so you can choose which ones you use, which ones you like, or you don't have to use them at all. I kind of like the Duke Nukem one every once in a while.
I see dead people.
Same thing down here. You can change the warning voice of your torpedo warning signal. I don't even think I use this one that much in game anymore. But again, completely cosmetic, personal. Down here, I like to be, this again, personal. It's purely cosmetic. I use the historical camo pack by Splinter because I like using, I'm a history lover, so I like to keep things as historical as possible. And then down here, I do use this one, anti-glare and fog remover. It just clears up your vision in game. And that's pretty much it. That's all I use, so I don't use a whole lot. So the most important ones in this, again, just to go over them real quick, if you're gonna use anything in this game that I would personally recommend is the crosshair, the crab crosshairs, crab hair version 1 or version 2, and then definitely the hit markers, the torpedo warning marker. You definitely want one of those. I recommend version 2 because again, it will make spotting them in game much easier. And then the info panel right here. So those are the three that I personally recommend that people get and use. And then all you have to do is click next, install them, and you are golden. And I just kind of lost my train of thought there. So the only other thing is, anytime that there is an update, whether it be World of Tanks or World of Warships, you do have to go in and reinstall and put all of these back, you know, these mods back on. So you'll have to do this process again. Sometimes you may have to wait a few hours or even as much as a day for Aslan's to go in and redo his mod files to make them current and work with the current update. So that's the only kind of downside to using these mods, is every time there's an update, you're gonna have to go back in and reinstall all your mods. Alright, with that being said, I hope this tutorial helps. Have a wonderful day, everyone.